name the chapter, recall the chapter that we were discussing. It is polynomial, right? Second chapter, and today's date is 18. Please go for writing today's date in your notebook. Name of the chapter is polynomial. And today's date, it is 18/6/2021. Dear students, with respect to the chapter polynomials, the last concept that we commenced to discuss, it was division algorithm for polynomials. As we are very familiar with the division of polynomials, just we record the statement of division algorithm for polynomials. We know that the terms involved in the division process are, one is dividend, second one is divisor, third one quotient, and fourth one is, it is remainder. So in case of polynomials, we will represent the dividend as P of x, divisor as g of x, quotient as q of x, and remainder polynomial as r of x. And we have also come to know the statement that we use to verify the division process. It is dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. And this can be expressed symbolically as p of x is equal to g of x into q of x plus r of x. And we will also follow a condition that while dividing the degree of p of x and g of x should be more than or equal to 1. This is first condition. And second condition is g of x, nothing but a divisor, it should not be equal to 0. G of x is not equal to 0, because in case if it becomes 0, then it will be undefined term in mathematics. Hence, we will follow these two conditions. In addition with that, after getting the remainder, you will come to know that the degree of the remainder will be less than the degree of the divisor. So till then, we have to continue division. So these are the three conditions that we follow in case of dividing a polynomial by another polynomial. So using this full information, we stated division algorithm for polynomials as, if p of x and g of x are any two polynomials of degree greater than or equal to 1, and g of x is not equal to 0, then there exist two unique polynomials, q of x and r of x, satisfying the statement that p of x is equal to g of x into q of x plus r of x, where the degree of remainder, that is r of x, is less than the degree of the g of x. So this was the statement. So now let's move on to solve the problems directly. So as we are very familiar with dividing a polynomial by another polynomial and verifying the statement, I'll go for taking just 2 to 3 statements with respect to this heading. Right up. Side heading. Oh, right. Worked examples. In that first one, the first one is right. Divide the polynomial directly as right. 2x square plus 3x plus 1 by x plus 2, full stop. Also, verify by division algorithm. Verified by division algorithm. You can start with me directly. Here, I'll write the solution. So let us assume the given polynomial as P of x. This is the dividend. Let us represent the dividend with P of x. And we have to write that in standard form. The given polynomial is already in standard form. Let's write directly. Right now. Let P of x is equal to 2x square plus 3x plus 1. It is already in standard form and no term is missing. Hence, we have written it directly. Next, g of x. Observe, even the g of x, nothing but divisor, is also in standard form. Write this as it is. Yes, let's start dividing. Write the divisor. It is x plus 2. And from this, we are going to divide P of x. That is 2x square plus 3x plus 1. In case of division process, in every step, we will go for equalizing the first term of dividend as well as divisor. Then here x is the first term. Here 2x square is first term. What should be multiplied with x? To get 2x square, it is 2x. I've already told you how to take that 2x as well. So now multiply 2x with both the terms. 2x into x, 2x square. Then 2x into 2, this is 4x. And leave one line for changing the sign. Here, plus is there. You can write it as minus. Here, plus is there. This is minus. While simplifying, consider here d sign. Here, 2x square minus 2x square get cancelled. Next, 3x minus 4x. It is minus x. Carry down 1. Next, observe the first term of both divisor and dividend. Here is x, here is minus x. Then what should be multiplied with x to get minus x? It is minus 1. So minus 1 into x is minus x. Then minus 1 into 2 is minus 2. Again, leave one line for writing the sign. Here minus is there. Write it as, make it as plus, and this is minus. Here also make it as plus. Now minus 1x plus 1x get cancelled. Then 1 plus 2, this is 3. Now we got the remainder 3. You may write the conclusion. That is, we got the quotient. Quotient is 2x minus 1. Then remainder is, it is 3. Yes. Now division is over. Now we are moving to verify this statement. That is verify by division algorithm, which means that you are going to verify the statement that whether P of x is equal to g of x into q of x plus r of x. Let's go for verification. Verification, I'll take RHS part. Where RHS part is, it is g of x into q of x plus r of x. Substitute where g of x is divisor, it is x plus 2. Q of x, we have already found out, even it has been written here, it is 2x minus 1 plus r of x remainder, this is 3. It is equal to, now multiply x with both the terms. Here x into 2x, 2x square, then x into minus 1 minus x. Next multiply 2 with both the terms. Here 2 into 2x, it is 4x. 4x, then 2 into minus 1, this is minus 2, then plus 3. It is equal to, let us simplify this. 2x square minus 1x plus 4x, it is plus 3x, then minus 2 plus 3 is plus 1. Observe, this is p of x. It is equal to p of x is LHS. RHS and LHS both are equal. Hence, you can say that division algorithm is verified. Right? Hence, it is verified. Over? Shama? Okay. Dear students, you all may be thinking that why this division process should be recalled. You know that how to find out the zeros of linear polynomial and quadratic polynomial. For linear polynomial, just we will go for transfer the terms. Whereas in quadratic polynomial, we will go for splitting the middle term, or we will factorize and then we will find out the zeros. But how to find out the zeros of cubic polynomial, biquadratic polynomial, quintic polynomial? So for all these, so our division algorithm or this division process will help us a lot. So I'll go for teaching you that how to find out the zeros of cubic polynomial and biquadratic polynomial using the division process. So before that, let me go for taking and two more problem. Right. Same type question. Second one. Right. Second one, you can put star mark, just a single star mark. It is divide x square plus 5 plus 3x cube plus x square by divide x square plus 5 plus 3x cube plus 2x, it is 2x by 1 plus 2x plus x square, and hence verify the division algorithm. Hence verify division algorithm. Division algorithm. Answer. First, you go through dividend as well as divisor. We have dividend as well as divisor. Are they in standard form? No. So the very first step that we have to follow is we have to write both the dividend and divisor in standard form. Karan Gowda, got it? First, we have to write them in standard form. Let's go for writing. Right, solution. Let P of x, that is nothing but dividend, it is and go for arranging the terms in the decreasing order of their powers. First 3x cube, next plus x square plus 2x plus 5. Next, divisor, that is g of x. Let us write it in standard form in the decreasing order of their power. First, highest power term is x square, followed by 8 plus 2x. Then, last term is, it is 1. Now, let's go for divide. Yes, start dividing. It is, first I'll write the divisor. Divisor is x square plus 2x plus 1. And the dividend is, it is 3x cube plus x square plus 2x plus 5. Here no term is missing. All terms are there. We have the term whose power is 3, power is 2, power is 1, and power is 0. So now let's go for dividing it directly. So to equalize first term, what should be multiplied with x square to get 3x cube? It is 3x. As I said, if you do not know, you can go for using working column. Take the first term of the dividend, that is 3x cube, and divide this by first term of the divisor, that is x square. Then x square get cancelled, you will get 3x. That 3x has been written here. Multiply 3x with all the three terms. 3x into x square, it is 3x cube. 3x into 2x, it is 6x square. 3x into 1, this is 3x. Now let's go for changing the sign. Here plus is there, write it as minus. Here minus, here minus. First term get cancelled. Second term, 1x square minus 6x square minus 5x square. Here plus 2x minus 3x minus 1x plus 5. Akansha MG, have you got same? Okay, good. Then Anaga and Patil. Here we have 5x minus 5x square. And the first term of the divisor is x square. X square get cancelled. You get minus 5. Write that minus 5 here. Multiply minus 5 with all the three terms. Minus 5 into x square minus 5x square minus 5 into 2x minus 10x minus 5 into 1 minus 5. Let us change the sign. Now here minus becomes plus, this is plus, and here also minus becomes plus. Minus 5x square plus 5x square get cancelled. Then minus 1x plus 10x, this will be 9x. Here plus 5 plus 5, it is plus 10. Is it possible to continue the division process? Can we continue? Karan Gowda, what do you say? Can we continue? Yes or no? No, it's not possible, because the degree of the remainder, compare that with the divisor, it is less than the divisor. You know, degree is 1, here degree is 2, hence it cannot be continued. You can stop over here only. We got quotient and remainder. Let me write. Therefore, the quotient is, that is q of x, it is 3x minus 5, and remainder r of x, this is 9x plus 10. We got p of x, g of x, q of x, and r of x. Now you can go for verifying the division algorithm. So let me verify that here.
Hello, Poyar. Have returned. Okay. Sarup, have you copied? Okay. Chirag. Karthik Q. Yes. Vaishnav BM. Okay. Now let's go for verifying the division process by division algorithm. Here I'm writing. Copy with me. Verification. First, I'll take RHS part, where RHS part is g of x into q of x plus r of x. G of x into q of x plus r of x. Divisor, quotient plus remainder. Now substitute. Vedavyas, are you writing? Continue to write. G of x, which is the divisor, x square plus 2x plus 1 into q of x, quotient that has been written here also. It is 3x minus 5 plus R of x, remainder polynomial is, it is 9x plus 10. Let's go for simplifying. First, let us simplify the first two terms. Multiply x square with both the terms. X square into 3x, it is 3x cube. X square into minus 5, minus 5x square. Now multiply 2x with both the terms. 2x into 3x, here 2 3s are 6, x into x, x square. That's 2x into minus 5, it is minus 10x. Now multiply by 1 with both the terms, 1 into 3x, it is 3x. 1 into minus 5, this is minus 5. Let's write the remaining term, that is 9x plus 10. This is equal. Let us go for simplifying it further by taking like terms. 3x cube as it is. Let us go for taking x square terms. Here minus 5x. Here plus 6x square. This will be minus 5 plus 6. It is plus 1. 1x square. Just I'll write x square. Next, x terms. Here 3x, here 9x, 12x, minus 10x, this will be minus 2x, 12 plus 2x, 3 plus 9, 12, plus 12, minus 10, it is plus 2. Next, 10 minus 5, this is plus 5. Also, this 3x cube, x square plus 2x plus 5. These are the terms of the given polynomial, that is dividend. It is nothing but p of x. So both LHS and RHS are equal. We will write it as LHS. Conclusion. Hence, it is verified. Now, I'll take one more. Shall I repeat? Vignesh MV. Shall I repeat? Okay. Bhumika, Sneha PB. Bhumika or Varnekar, shall I repeat? Okay. Hello,
Right. Third one
is divide. Divide
x raised to the power 4 minus 5x plus 6 by 2 minus x square. 2 minus x square. Please observe the terms. Whether the terms of the dividend, are they in standard form? Are they in standard form? Of course, they are in standard form, but some terms are missing. Could you identify those missing terms? Look here, x raised to the power 4 is there, but is there 3? X cube is there? Here is no x cube, no x square as well. They are the missing terms. So in place of those, you may write 0.
Is right. Let P of x is equal to x raised to the power 4. There is no x cube term, hence I'll write it as 0 into x cube. There is no x square term, I'll write 0 into x square. Next, minus 5x plus 6. Next, g of x. In g of x, we have 2 minus x square. You can write in this in standard form as minus x square plus 2. But a term is missed. What is that missing term? It is x term. Here is x square, but there is no x term. Hence, I'll write minus x square plus 0 into x plus 2. Now let us start divide. First write the divisor. Divisor is minus x square plus 0 into x plus 2. From this, we have to divide x raised to the power 4 plus 0 into x cube plus 0 into x square minus 5x plus 6. Now equalize the first term of both. Here minus x square. Here is x raised to the power 4. What should be multiplied with minus x square? What can be multiplied? Here is minus x square. X raised to the power 4 is there. You can multiply minus x square. Minus x square into minus x square, it is plus x raised to the power 4. If you do not know, you may use working column. That is, first term of the dividend is x raised to the power 4. First term of the divisor is minus x square. X square and here x square get cancelled. X square will remain. Here it is minus x square. Multiply minus x square with all the terms. With the first term, it will be x raised to the power 4 minus x square into 0. It is 0 minus x square into 2. It is minus 2x square. Change the sign. This is minus and is minus. This is plus. X raised to the power 4 minus x raised to the power 4 get cancelled. Next, here 0 minus 0, 0 only. Next, here 0 plus 2, it is 2. 2x square. Next, minus 5x plus 6. Finished up? Have you finished? Okay. Now let us equalize the first term of this dividend and this divisor. Here 2x square is there, 2x square divided by. The first term of the divisor is minus x square. See that here x square get cancelled. Minus
2 will remain. Let me write that here. Minus 2 into minus x square is plus 2x square. Minus 2 into 0 is, this is 0. Minus 2 into plus 2, this is minus 4, because 2 2s are 4. It is change the sign. Here is minus, this plus becomes minus, minus becomes plus as we subtract. Now simplify it. 2x square minus 2x square get cancelled. Next, minus 5x minus 0. It is minus 5x. Next, 6 plus 4. It is 10. Whether further division is possible? No, because you can recall the reason that the degree of the remainder is less than the degree of the divisor. Hence, you can write directly the quotient and remainder. Write down the conclusion. Therefore, quotient polynomial is, it is minus x square minus 2. And the remainder polynomial, r of x is equal to minus 5x plus 10. Got it? So now let me go for rubbing this. Listen. Now I'll go for taking one more problem. Again, it is related to division, not just direct division. Look here. Here I'll write 15. We know that 15 can be divided by 3 completely, can also be divided by 5. Then, when you divide 15 by either 3 or 5, what will be the remainder? Remainder will be 0. Then, if remainder comes as 0, what do you say about 3 and 5 with respect to 15? Very good. Deepashri KJ, she is responding. Very good. 3 and 5 are factors of 15. Because these are the number which divide the given number completely, where the remainder would be 0. Even in case of division of polynomial, if the remainder comes out as 0, r of x is equal to 0, then can we say that g of x is a factor of p of x? Can we tell so? This you had already learned in 9th standard is a theorem called factor theorem. If remainder comes out to be as 0, g of x is the factor. If remainder is not equal to 0, then g of x is not a factor of p of x. So now I'm going to take one such statement right now. Write the question. It is, check whether fourth one, check whether the polynomial x cube minus 3x plus 1, x cube minus 3x plus 1 is a factor of x raised to the power 5 minus 4x cube plus x square plus 3x plus 1. X raised to the power 5 minus 4x cube plus x square plus 3x plus 1. Observe. You know that here the first polynomial x cube minus 3x plus 1 is, it is a dividend. No, very good. It is divisor, because from this polynomial only we are going to divide this. And x raised to the power 5 minus 4x cube plus x squared plus 3x plus 1, it is the dividend. First one is divisor, second one is dividend. You are going to check whether first polynomial is a factor of second polynomial. If you want to check that, you have to divide second polynomial by first polynomial. If the remainder comes out to be as zero, it's a factor. If not, it is not a factor. Got it? Very simple way. Right. Verification. Because we are going to check whether it is a factor or not. Let me write the divisor. Here, a term is missing. That is x square. I'll write x cube plus 0 into x square. Next, minus 3x plus 1. From this, we have to divide the dividend, that is 5, x raised to the power 5. There is no x raised to the power 4 term. That term is missing. In place of that, I'll write 0 into x raised to the power 4. Next, minus 4x cubed plus x square plus 3x plus 1. What should be multiplied with x cube to get x raised to the power 5? It is x square. Multiply x square with all the terms. X square into x cube. It is x raised to the power 5. X square into 0. This is 0. X square into minus 3x. It is minus 3x cube. X square into 1. It is 1x square. Change the sign. It is minus, minus, plus. This is minus. 1x raised to the power 5 minus 1x raised to the power 5 get cancelled. And 0 minus 0, it is 0. Now 4 minus 4x cube plus 3x cube. It will be minus x cube. Next. Here, 1x square minus 1x square, it cancels. This is, you can write plus 0. Next, plus 3x plus 1 as it is. Now, observe here minus x cube, there, x cube is there. To equalize that, we can multiply minus 1. So, minus 1 into x cube, it is minus x cube. Minus 1 into 0, it is 0. Minus 1 into minus 3x, it is plus 3x. Then minus 1 into 1, it is minus 1. Let's go for changing the sign. Here, plus, this is minus. This is minus. Here is plus. First term get cancelled. Second term get cancelled. Third term get cancelled. Last term, see that? Plus 1, plus 1. It is 2. Remainder is 2. Whether remainder is equal to 0? Whether remainder is equal to 0? No. If the remainder is not equal to 0, then what do you say about first polynomial? Is it a factor? No, it is not a factor. Yes, very good. Hope that you all have understood. So write the conclusion. Right. Remainder, R of x, it is 2 and is not equal to 0. R of x is not equal to 0. You may recall that factor theorem which I had used in the last year. By factor theorem, x cube minus 3x plus 1 is not a factor. X cube minus 3x plus 1 is not a factor. Is not a factor. Let me take one last one. Right. Fifth one. Check whether p square minus three. Is a factor of 2 into t raised to the power 4 plus 3t cube minus 2t square minus 9t minus 12. You are going to check whether t square minus 3 is a factor of 2 t raised to the power 4 plus 3 t raised to the power 3 minus 2 t raised to the power 2 minus 9 t minus 12. Let us go for checking it out. So far we have taken the variable x only, but here they have given t as variable. Right, verification. So let us write the divisor in standard form. You know that in the divisor t square minus 3, the term t is missed. So that should be taken as 0 into t. Right? It is t square plus 0 into t minus 3. Next, dividend. It is in standard form only and no terms are missed. Let us write it directly. 2 t raised to the power 4 plus 3 t cube minus 2 t square minus 9 t. Minus 12. So what should be multiplied with t square to get 2 t raised to the power 4? Rakin, you can tell that by observing your lips movement, I can understand whether it is correct or not. What should be multiplied with t square to get 2 t raised to the power 4? Yes, it is 2 t square. Now see that t square into t square, t raised to the power 4 into 2, right? 2 t raised to the power 2 t square into 0, it is 0 1. 2 t square minus 3, it is minus 6 t square. Let us go for changing the sign. Go on writing with me, Rakhil. It is minus, this is minus, and is plus. First term, get cancer. Observe second term, 3t cube minus 0, it is 3t cube only. Here, minus 2t square plus 6t square, it is 4t square. Next, minus 9t minus 12 as it is. Again, equalize the first term. What should be multiplied with t square to get 3t cube? It is 3t. If you do not know, use working column. First term is 3t cube, and there first term of the divisor is t square. Here, square and power get cancelled. You will get 3t. That has been written here. Multiply 3t with all the terms. 3t into t square, it is 3t cube. 3t into 0, this is 0. 3t into minus 3, it is minus 9t. Change the sign. This is minus and is minus, this is plus. First term get cancelled. As the terms are same and sign are different. Next, 4t square minus 0, it is 4t square. Next, 9t plus 9t, get cancelled, it is 0. Minus 12 as it is. Now again, I'll take the first term, that is 4t square, and the first term of the divisor, it is t square. T square get cancelled, you get 4. Let me write that 4 here. Multiply 4 into t square, 4t square. 4 into 0, it is 0. 4 into minus 3, it is minus 12. Ashutosh, have you copied this? Okay. Now, change the sign. This is minus, minus, and is plus. First term get cancelled, second term get cancelled, third term get cancelled. The remainder is 0. Here, in this case, remainder is 0. By a factor theorem, we can say that t square minus 3 is the factor of the given polynomial. So, let us write. Here, I'll write. It is r of x, sorry, r of t, remainder polynomial is 0. Now, here I'm going. By factor theorem, it is t square minus 3 is a factor of, you may write it as p of t, where p of t is the dividend. Follow? Yes. Hey, students, now we are moving to the application of the division algorithm for polynomials. Just so far we recalled the division process, how to find out the quotient and remainder, and how to check whether the dividend is a factor of divisor is a factor of dividend or not. That we have come to know. Now let's move on to its application. Then what is its application? As I said in the beginning of today's class, this process is used for finding the zeros of cubic polynomial, biquadratic polynomial, and so on. Got it? The first, finding the zeros of first two types are known. Now let us focus on cubic as well as biquadratic. Just right-sided it. Applications of applications are.
Division algorithm for polynomials. Applications of division algorithm.
Sir, unmute your radio. Sir, unmute your radio.
Yes. Applications of division algorithm for polynomials.
So as I said, this division algorithm is used for finding the zeros of cubic and biquadratic. So in the examination point of view, we have up to biquadratic one. Now let me go for taking some problems on this.
Just observe here. Okay. Look at the board, Sumit. Here, I'll go for dividing 256 by 4. For dividing, you can follow like this, the general method. 256, it should be divided by 4. And we will write it as 6 are 24, 1 will remain, carry down 6. Then 4 fours are 16, it is 0. Then we can write 256 as 4 into 64, right? 256 is the product of divisor and quotient. Can we write this as 4 into 8 into 8? Can we write
64?
Of course. Look at 64 is written as 8 into 8. And can we write the 64 in another term as it is
4 cube?
4 in directly. 4 cube. Or as 4 into 16. Can we write so?
Yes, sir.
Look here. From this, we can come to know that 256 can be divided by these two terms, which are the factors of 256. And the factors of 64 are also the factors of 256. Is it not? 64 is written as 8 into 8. 64 is also written as 8 into 16. So 8 and 16, they are also the factors of 256. So even in case of division process also, we will follow the same. How it is? Let me explain that with an example. Right. It is very important type of problem in the examination point of view. The question will be given like this. Put three star mark. It is find all the zeros of zeros of 2x raised to the power 4 minus 3x cubed minus 3x square plus 6x minus 2. Question has not yet been completed. Just go through that step. You know, this is the given polynomial. Nishka, look at the board. Could you tell what type of polynomial it is? Biquadratic.
Biquadratic polynomial. Then how many zeros it has?
Four.
So here the symbol. If it is inevitable to respond, then you can unmute. Its degree is 4, hence it has 4 zeros, and those 4 zeros are alpha, beta, gamma, and delta. If it is linear or quadratic, we know how to find out the zeros. We will equate the given polynomial to 0, then we will go for solving the unknown term. But here, can we take this biquadratic polynomial equal to 0 and factorizing? We find it very difficult. It can be done, but we find it very difficult. So that to make it as simple, we will go for division process. Then you all may be again thinking that, sir, you are telling that division process, but there is no divisor only. So we will get that divisor. How? For obtaining the divisor, they only will give some zeros. Four zeros is it has 4 zeros because it is a biquadratic. Avru en martare andre they will give you 2 zeros and they'll ask us to find out other 2 zeros. Did you understand? 2 zeros avru kortare, 2 zeros now find out maadbeku. Continue the question. Come on. If 2 of its zeros are 2 of its zeros are root 2 and minus root 2. Root 2 and minus root 2. Please don't write, just observe. Listen. This is the biquadratic polynomial. It has 4 zeros. They have given 2 zeros. We have to find out other 2 zeros. To find out other 2 zeros, we have to form a polynomial from the given zeros. Okay, these are the given zeros. Very better. Just look here. One is root 2 and another one is minus root 2. You know that how to find out how to form a polynomial when zeros are known. Then how can I form this? Will you go for finding the sum of zeros, product of zeros? Adhu sarpa jaasti time aagu. You can do that. Like sum of zeros. Sum is root 2. Then plus of minus root 2 get cancelled. It will be 0. And the product is root 2 into minus root 2. This will be minus 2. Then you use P of x is equal to x square minus sum into x plus product, and this is equal to x square minus sum is 0 into x plus product minus 2. This is x square minus 2. It's a long process, Agatalva. We can make it a shortcut. I'll tell you that how it is. Nikhil, please don't try it. Just observe. The given zeros are x equal to root 2 and x equal to minus root. We want the quadratic polynomial. And here we take that quadratic polynomial as divisor. Hence it is represented as g of x. It is equal to, take root 2 to the left hand side. It will be minus root. So it is x minus root. Next, transfer minus root 2 to the left hand side. X plus root 2. It is of the form a plus b, and this is a minus a square minus b square. A square is x square minus b square is root 2 whole square. It is 2. See that? Directly we can write. It takes more number of steps, but it is shortcut. Artha itara? Do you have any doubt?
Please
any doubt?
Again,
yes
sir.
Or no?
Sir, explain once again, sir.
Sir, explain once again, sir.
Once I explain, Iga, we have learned how to form a quadratic polynomial when zeros are given. These are the zeros. X equal to root 2 and x is equal to minus root 2. Amele en martidre? X minus root 2 is equal to 0. And this is x plus root 2 equal to 0. Then x minus root 2 into x plus root 2 is equal to 0. Then we used to write it as x square minus 2 is equal to 0. And this is to be taken as polynomial. Shortcut method alli bariyodakke I am writing this step directly. Root 2 ide x minus root 2 minus root 2 ide x plus root 2. That's all. Understood? Barichina root 3 and minus root 3 anta ide. You can write directly as g of x is equal to x minus root 3. And this is x
plus root
3. It is equal to, it is x square minus 3.
Minus so, 3.
7 and 10 quadra. 7 and 10 quadra. How do you write? G of
x minus 7.
X minus 7. Into
x minus 10.
Minus 10.
You will find out g of x. Got it? This is a simple way. Please do remember. And now you'll go on writing with me. Start writing. First, let us find out g of x. Right. Solution. They have given two zeros. Let us say the first zero as x and second zero as x is equal to minus root. ನಿಮಗೆ ಮತ್ತೆ ಏನೋ ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಬಿಕೆ ಒನ್ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ ನ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಮಾಡಿ ಹಿಂಗೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ x ಮೈನಸ್ ರೂಟ್ ಟು ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಝೀರೋ ಅಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ x ಪ್ಲಸ್ ರೂಟ್ ಟು ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಝೀರೋ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಯು ರೈಟ್ g of x ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಎರಡನ್ನು ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡಿ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ x ಮೈನಸ್ ರೂಟ್ ಟು ಅಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ x ಪ್ಲಸ್ ರೂಟ್ ಟು this is equal is of the form a plus b to a minus b can be written as a square minus b x square minus 2 we got g of next let us go for dividing the given biquadratic polynomial by this divisor start dividing here I write the divisor is there is no x zero minus
sir the other zeros are 1 and 1 by 2 sir
yeah very good okay right it is 2x raised to the power 4 minus 3x cube minus x square plus minus 2. Start dividing. Raised to the power 4 is there here x square. What should be multiplied? You have to multiply.
2x square.
2x square. Multiply 2x square with all the terms. 2x square into x square. 2x raised to the power 4. 2x square into 0. 0. 2x square into minus 2. Minus 4x square. Next. Change the sign. It is minus. Here is minus. Here is plus. The first term get cancelled. Second term, minus 3x cube minus 0. It is minus 3x cube only. Next, minus 3x square plus 4x square. It is plus 1x square z plus 6x minus 2 as t. Equalize again. So we have to, what should be multiplied with x square to get minus 3x cube? Very good.
Minus.
Minus 3.
Minus 3x.
Minus 3x.
Multiply minus 3x with all the terms. Minus 3x into x square is minus 3x cube. Minus 3x into 0 is 0. Minus 3x into minus 2 is plus 3x. Sorry, plus 6x. Change the sign. This is plus is minus. This is minus. First term get cancelled. Second term, x square minus 0, it is x square. Third term, 6x minus 6x get cancelled. This is 0. Minus 2 will remain. Now, to equalize first term with x square, I'll go for multiplying 1. 1 into x square is x square. 1 into 0 is 0. 1 into minus 2 is minus. Again, change the sign. Minus, minus, plus. First term get cancelled, second term get cancelled, third term also get cancelled. It is 0. Followed. Now you just observe it. Look here. This is the divisor from this. How many zeros are there? 2 zeros. They only had given 2 zeros, root 2 and minus root 2. From that we have found this polynomial. And we know that as the remainder is equal to 0, this is a factor, one thing. And this dividend is equal to the product of divisor and quotient. Got it? Andre, e formula ide. P of x is equal to g of x into q of x. Ege namage idu factors already gottide. G of x, it is root 2 minus root 2 zeros here. And here observe q of x. What type of polynomial it is? Quadratic polynomial. Alva, how many zeros it has? 2 zeros. Quadratic polynomial has 2 zeros. You can find out those 2 zeros from this. Understood? Arthaitala? Yes or no? Yes, okay.
Zeros now, are 1 and 1 by 2.
Let me go for finding the remaining 2 zeros from the quotient part. I'll write that here. Just below this, right? The quotient is 2x square minus 3x plus 1. From this, let us find out other 2 zeros. It is, as we are going to find out the zeros, equate this to 0. Now let us go for factorizing this by multiply first and last term. 2 and 1. 2 ones are 2. You directly bari bodu, but anyhow, I am showing the detailed steps. Your middle term is minus 3. Factors of 2 to get minus 3.
Minus 2, minus 1.
2 ones are 2, 2 plus 1 is 3, but we want minus 3. Hence it is minus 2, this is minus 1. Right. 2x square minus 3x is written as minus 2x minus 1x plus 1 is equal to 0.
Sir, x is equal to 1 by 2 and x is equal to 1, sir.
Oh, correct. Now, group them by taking 2 terms. In first group, 2x is common factor. Remaining 2x into x, 2x square minus 2x into 1, 2x. Next. Here, in the second group, 1 is common factor. I'll take minus 1 as common factor. Minus 1 into x minus x. Minus 1 into minus 1, it is plus 1. Equal to 0. In the whole statement, x minus 1 is common factor. Remaining will be 2x minus 1 equal to 0. Next. X minus 1 is equal to 0. And 2x minus 1. 2x minus 1 equal to 0. X equal to 1. And here also you can solve x. 2x equal to
1 by 2, sir.
1 by 2, sir. Another 2 zeros.
Observe. These are the other 2 zeros. 1 and 1 by 2. Obtain, find all the zeros and the elder. They have given 2 zeros, root 2 and minus 2. And we have found out other 2 zeros, 1 and 1 by 2. Ends. Right. Therefore, the zeros are, I'll write all of them. One is root 2, another one is minus root 2, third one is 1, and fourth one is 1 by 2. These are the zeros. This is very important in the examination point of view. Almost, we can say that 100% this type will be there in the examination. Many times they have asked the question like this. Obtain all the zeros of the polynomial when its two zeros are there or when its one zero is there. Or it is quartic. Now, I'll go for taking another one.
For how many marks?
It is for 3 marks. Depends. Even it can also be given for 4 marks. Depends on the given zeros. Other may not depend. Right. Next one. Example. And it is also from the textbook. Next one. Right. Obtain all other zeros. Right.
Veda Vyas BJ. Veda Vyas BJ.
Right.
Veda Vyas BJ. I am reading you. Huh? Useless for.
Right. Obtain all other zeros. Obtain all other zeros of right 3x raised to the power 4 plus 6x cubed minus 2x squared minus 10x minus 4 would come up if two of its zeros are two of its zeros are right root 5 by 3 and minus root 5 by 3. This was given in the examination. Same problem. Without changing even statement, I've given this as it is. Once I read, it is 3x raised to the power 4 plus 6x cubed minus 2x squared minus 10x minus 5. Yes, it is correct. First, you'll go for forming a polynomial using these two zeros. Do that job. Find out. Nishka, find it out.
Suraj bhi right there. Suraj bhi right there.
X square minus y by 3, sir.
Carry on. Just a minute.
Three x square minus 5, sir.
Wait.
Suraj, we right there. You have been working class or working somewhere? This is the last time.
Hope that you have finished. Have you finished?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. And if you have written, just a cross, sir. If not, you can just go on writing with me. They have given two zeros. These are the two zeros. I'll take first one. Let x is equal to square root of 5 by 3. And another zero, x equal to minus square root of 5 by 2. And I'm writing g of x directly is equal to, it is x minus root 5 by 3. It is x plus root 5 by 3. This will be easier. Is of the form a plus b into a minus b. Can be written as a square minus b square. That is root 5 by 3 whole square. Here square and root get cancelled. This is x square minus 5 by 3. Hope that you have got this much. And this is equal to, you know, denominator. It is in fraction. So that is why I go for multiplying 3 with all the terms. It is 3x square minus 5, where constant is 3. Denominator 3, thereby even now constant in the third. So g of x is equal to 3x square minus 5. Have you got same? Sumit?
Yes, sir.
Got same?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Chinmay? Arshapiyan? Okay. Yes. Jayan K? Okay. Now let us divide the given polynomial using this. Right. The divisor is 3x square. There is no x term. Hence, I'll write it as 0 into x and constant minus 5. From this, we have to divide the given polynomial. It is 3x raised to the power 4 plus 6x cube minus 2x square minus 10x minus 5. As it is in standard form and no terms are missed, I have written this as it is. Now, let us multiply with suitable term. 3x square, it should be multiplied by x square to get
3x square
to the power 4. X square into 3x square is 3x raised to the power 4. X square into 0, it is 0. X square into minus 5, minus 5x square. Change the sign. This is minus, yes, minus, and it is plus. First term, get cancelled. Second term, 6x cube minus 0, it is just 6x cube. Then minus 2x square plus 5x square, it is plus 3x square. Minus 10x minus 5 as it is. Now what should be multiplied with 3x squared to get 6x cube?
2x.
Very good. It is 2x. Now 2x into 3x square is 6x cube. 2x into 0. This is 0 minus 2x into 5. 10. 10x. Minus, minus, plus. First term get cancelled. Second term, 3x square minus 0, it is 3x square. Minus 10x plus 10x get cancelled, this is 0. Next, minus 5. Your 3x square is there. What should be multiplied with 3x square to get this? 3x square. 3x square. Then 1 into 0, it is 0. 1 into minus 5, it is minus. Again, change the sign. This is minus, minus, plus.
Zero.
First term, third term. All the terms get cancelled. Remainder is 0.
Sir, the other zeros are minus 1 and minus 1.
And minus 1.
Yes, very good. So, Sahib, you are right. Now, I'll continue from here. Jen, have you copied? Okay. Good. Amrita, yes, Melody? Copied? Okay.
Vijay, minus one, sir. Zeros.
Okay. Now, let us go for finding these zero terms. This question.
Yeah, I tell you, I'm
keeping 2x plus 2x plus 1. Right. Plus 2x plus 1. As we are going to find out the zeros, it should be equated to 0. Listen here. If any unwanted sound is coming from your home, please unmute. Sorry, please mute that. Or else it will be a disturbance for others. Okay. Also, multiply first and last term. Here one and here one. One ones are one. And the middle term is two. Then factors are one and one. One ones are one. 1 plus 1 is 2. So here I'll write x square.
Minus 1.
2x can be written as 1x plus 1x. It is 1x plus 1x plus 1 equal to 0. Group them and take the common factor. Here in the first group, x is common factor, it will be x plus 1. In the second group, we have no common factor other than 1. Hence, I take 1 as common factor. 1 into x. 1 x. 1, 1's of 1. This is equal to 0. In the whole statement, x plus 1 is common factor. This is x plus 1. And the remaining is, it is x plus 1 equal to 0. Equate each term to 0. X plus 1 equal to 0 and x plus 1 equal to 0. Find out x. X is equal to minus 1. Means
minus 1.
1 to the right hand side, you'll get minus 1. Next, x is equal to minus 1. So, honey, have you got? The given zeros are root 5 by 3 and minus root 5 by 3. And the obtained other two zeros are minus 1 and minus 1. You can count the total number of zeros. Vijayalakshmi, you can count the total number of zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4. Observe. The given polynomial is biquadratic. It has four zeros. They had given two zeros. We have found out other two zeros. Now let us write for all the four zeros. Right, conclusion. Therefore, the four zeros are, or else all the zeros are, the four zeros are root 5 by 3 minus root 5 by 3 minus 1 and minus 1. Vijay Lakshmi, did you tell them to go that side? Huh? No, no, they were enjoying the class, no? Let them enjoy. It's okay.
Sir, these
are the four zeros. Okay. Hope that you have copied. Repeatedly, I have been telling, this is one of the type of problem which will be asked in the examination without fail. Got it? Finding the zeros and verifying the relationship between zeros and coefficient and obtaining all the zeros. You are really 100% examiner. You have to practice. By the time exam will be approaching, you will be able to guess the type of questions to be asked in the examination. Out of 80 marks, every student can guess minimum 50 marks. Minimum 50 marks, neve guess martide without fail. Just, but you must have the good analyzation. To enhance your analyzation, I'll be giving you the hint. Adanna you use martta irbeku so that it will be easy for you to guess the some number of marks. But your concentration is to get highest marks. Nim kelu friends irtarla who are poor in studies. For them, you can go for helping them. You can give them confidence that, yes, I'm going to give you some of the question. You just go for reading them. It is enough to get minimum 50 marks out of 80. But your target should be to get full marks, 80 out of 80. Got it? Okay. Dear students, and one more information. This coming Sunday, you have parent-teacher meeting, parent-teacher-students meeting. Please inform your parent. And the second thing, you have test on Sunday, weekly test will be there. And the chapter is polynomials only. Whatever we cover till Saturday, I think probably this chapter will be completed by Saturday only. Full chapter will be given for weekly test. And third one, third important point is you have to practice the problems what I have solved, particularly today. In this chapter only, you can guess the most commonly questions to be asked in the examination. One is finding the zeros of the quadratic polynomial and verify the relationship between zeros and coefficient. 100% question it is. Second thing, if alpha and beta are the zeros of the given polynomial, then you have to form new polynomial when new zeros are given. New zeros kottaga new polynomial na form madu. And third one is obtain all the zeros when two zeros of the given polynomial are given. These two kuda most commonly questions to be asked. And remaining one mark, two mark, so bare regional character step. Okay, now it is time up. And last information, yesterday we conducted the online performance test. A good number of students have attempted, but I never think about the students who have not attended. I know that they are not interested in. And even some students, they have attempted carelessly. I won't go for considering such students as my students. But many students, they have taken it seriously and they are putting their effort sincerely, Really, I appreciate such students. And your graph, definitely, if you go on attempting all the tests, what I'm going to conduct, and your performance graph will be increasing like this. Finally, you will reach to a very good level, which is called no match level. Not just good, very good, excellent, tremendous. Other than that, no match level. You can reach to no match level. Okay, with this,
sir,
let us stop the class.
Thank
you very much. Have a wonderful day.
Thank you, sir.